Hello everyone, we're gonna build the vent today. So this is a nice piece of area train you can use on an industrial themed table. It's a small sub-assembly before you go onto painting, and then after that we're gonna come back and do the final assembly for you guys. So the first thing we're gonna do, and the only thing we're gonna do before we're gonna paint, is to glue this van to the back of this plate, and we're gonna use this to make sure that the alignment is perfect. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna flip this one. In order to make sure that this is perfectly aligned with the grating that's already there, we're gonna use this circle. Why? This circle, if you align that with the grate, it's the same dimensions, because it's actually the trim piece is gonna be added to the other side after this. We can make sure that the vent and the fan are perfectly aligned. So once we're doing this, we're gonna take this away. We're gonna add some glue to this. So what we're gonna do is, making sure this doesn't move, we're gonna add a little bit of glue to the grating to make sure that the fan won't show any glue spots. What you see is that the fan is not fully symmetrical. This part, this fan blade is a little bit higher than this one. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna have a bead of glue on this side, this height, and then one slightly lower on the other half. So keeping in mind to keep the trim piece in place, try and use as small a dot as you can manage, depending on what kind of glue you're using. Make sure to get an asymmetrical line. So just make sure to break when you, once you hit the center one, make sure to break and bring it down a little. Then just add the fan on top. Making sure the fan, the trim piece is in place, so you can use that to align the fan. So once you've done that, make sure to give it a little bit of general pressure. Then you can move the ring. What you can see is that there's some glue spillage in there. We're just gonna take some extra MDF cutouts, and we're gonna make sure to remove that now as it's still wet. And then after that, we're gonna leave it to dry for a little bit. And after that, we will paint it and come back to you guys. So welcome back everyone. So we gave it a quick paint job. What you see, what we do with most of our kits, is we use contrasting colors on different layers in order to give the piece more depth. So what we did is we painted the central portion with the fan and the grate. We painted it in a silver color, and then we added a bit of a rusty brown red to both the trim piece, is gonna end up on top, and the layer that's gonna go all the way underneath. So the last steps that we're gonna do is to glue all this together. So the first stage is to glue the trim piece on here. You can use the inside of the grate to match the inside of this circle, and that way it aligns perfectly and you get the best finish. So just make sure that you don't put too much glue on this, because everything's painted, it's gonna be harder to get rid of everything afterwards. And you're always gonna have a little bit of a shine if you have some dried wood glue on there. So try and do it as clean as you can. What you can do when you put the glue on it is just take your finger and spread, just tap the glue a little bit, just to take the excess glue off. So you have less glue that's gonna flow out into the centers. So once you've done this, added the glue, just make sure to add it to this piece and make sure to align the outside edge of the grate with the inside edge of the trim piece. Take your time, do this properly, because you can only do it once. As you'll see, because the dimensions are almost perfectly identical, thank you laser cutters, it's quite easy to do this. But still make sure, because it's quite a thin piece, you can warp it a little. So just make sure to give it a good walk around, check it a little bit. Yeah, that looks okay. Then just remove any excess glue you might still have. It shouldn't be too much, because you used very little glue and took away most of the excess already. So the most you're going to see here is probably where the trim piece hits the grate, as there's more connection space there. So clean off any excess on the edge. actually looks pretty good. So once you're done, you're gonna have a piece that looks like this. So you have the trim piece glued to the center portion of the vent area. Then the last bit is just to put some glue on this, glue it together, and then we're done. For this as well, make sure to put a nice bit of glue all around. So take the edge into account mostly. Try to avoid the center bit as much as you can, because it's gonna be really hard to get the glue out of there, because there's more detail in that area. Make sure to get all the edges, put a couple of small dots in areas where you don't really wanna have a complete line of glue. And then after that's completed, just take this, take your the lowest portion of the vent area, align it, and there should be an equal gap all the way around. You can use the trap doors that are also in the center, which actually align with the edging at the trim piece around it to help you align the entire piece in general. Make sure to give it a good bit of general pressure to make sure the glue is completely spread out. There's no like high spots. After you've done that, just make sure to check that you're happy with the alignment. Just remove any excess that you might still have. Shouldn't be too much. I think it's pretty much okay. So once you're done, you end up with this final product. Of course, you can take some weathering powders to this, do some dry brushing to finish it off and blend it into your, the rest of your table. We got a small example here. So this is what we've done for our desert table. So we took some sandy dust colors and some light bone colors to dry brush and spray it in to make sure it blends well into like a desert type of scenery. So that's what you can do. So I hope you enjoyed it, and good luck building. See you next time.